I got two things to say. Don't let your kids shoot Nerf bullets at your TV. Second thing is, if you've got an old TV like this, or you can get a hold of one, you can actually recycle it into a really cool shop or studio light. And that's what we're gonna do. Let's get started. If you're ever taking apart electronics, especially TVs or monitors, be really careful of capacitors. So these guys right here are called capacitors. And these guys, they're gonna store and hold electricity, enough electricity to hurt you or even kill you sometimes. Even if the unit's unplugged, you don't wanna touch the kind of the connecting parts the capacitors are, because you might get shocked. So just be careful not to touch those guys. One of the first things we're gonna kind of take apart are the connection points to the LCD screen. So the very first layer on the top of the TV is the liquid crystal displays, and that's what broke on this TV. And these little connection points here and here feed that signal, so we don't need these. These are the first ones we're gonna take apart. The goal of this disassemble is to essentially take everything out, find the leads through the LEDs, which I think are under here, connect to those electronic leads and see what voltage they're pulling. So there's gonna be a bunch of layers on this TV. That first one was the LCD crystal, that's the glass, and the LCD pixels that cracked with the Nerf bullet. The next layer is an important layer you wanna save. This is the diffusing filter, which really makes this whole project key. This helps diffuse the light, makes it look really good for when you're doing film production. So you wanna keep this. This one's also important. It gets the light beams and it kind of refracts them. This one's important too, keep it. We're gonna test anyway and see what they look like with these filters on and off. And under here are the bulbs, I think. There we go. What I like to do is find out where the leads come in. There's only three pathways that you're gonna take when you're converting a busted LCD flat screen TV. And those three pathways have some pros and cons. So when you take the TV apart, you could just take out the lenses and the filters and then throw away the busted LCD crystal display. It's really important to keep these lenses and filters in the same order that they were laid out on the TV. Take the broken screen out, put the lenses right back into the TV. Don't do anything else. And you'll have a working shop light. You hit the power button on the remote, the lights will come on, no problem. But there's two issues with that. You're gonna be powering all these components for no reason. So you're gonna be wasting a bunch of power when all you really need to do is get power to the lights on. The second problem with that pathway, which is the easiest and quickest, is that the TV is going to think it's still functioning. It's going to want to change the lights as the screensaver comes on. And you may even get the TV automatically turning off because of inactivity, and then the power saver mode turns everything off. And so if you're doing a film or you're a shop light, that TV is going to be turning on and off and doing some funky behavior. So if you're okay with that, no problem. Go with pathway number one. Second pathway to getting this to work as a shop light is tearing it all down, taking everything out, removing all the components and feeding power straight to these LED strip bars. Oftentimes that's not as easy as you think, because I thought maybe there'd just be like a little positive and negative lead at the top of each bar and I can solder to it. It's actually not. There's actually about 10 positive and negatives, tiny ones on each bar. Still not insurmountable. I'm gonna go ahead and go with pathway number two. I bought a soldering gun and I'm gonna solder wire to these leads. Pick up a little 24 volt adapter, get the leads in line, and then I can actually just use that adapter to turn the lights on and off. The third way you can do it is take everything out, even the LED lights, and pick up a little $20 kit of just regular LED lights as well. Line those from behind, put the filters back on, and then problem solved as well. Because the real value of this TV are not so much these bulbs, but that those filters and those diffusers, and then the carcass itself. So three choices, three pathways. I'm gonna go with number two to see if I can get these soldered on, and we'll go from there. Here we go, moment of truth. It was the first soldering attempt. If I'm successful, this whole row right here will light up. Yeah, all of them light up except for the last four. I gotta figure that out. All right, attempt number two. I kinda re-soldered it a little bit. Success! Got the whole run all the way lit. How many more? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven more to go. All right, all the soldering's done. I've got half of the bars hooked up. Everything looks good. I just want to do a test with this power adapter to see if anything gets hot. I want to see if it runs for maybe a half hour. Evaluate the brightness, whether or not I need to get another one with a higher amperage. I don't even know what this one is. This is 2 amps, 24 volts. So if you do turn it down, it does work. That's as high as it goes right there, 24 volts. But I'll wait a little bit and hook up all of them and do a test. So far so good.
So I've got all the soldering done. Like I said before, I did a test. The solders aren't pretty, but put all the positive leads together and the negative leads together into a single wire here. Test was fine, meaning the adapter didn't get hot. All the lights turned on, looks good. Then I ordered a pretty cool looking digital readout voltage converter. I thought it was the right one. I thought actually this could be used for 120 in the socket wall. Turns out I plug it in and it blew up right in my face and it just destroyed this thing. So 30 bucks down the drain, I got a new one on order. But in the meantime, I'm gonna start on the PVC build and build the stand for it.
Picked up a replacement power supply. This one had some pretty good reviews. I'll leave the link down below. I don't have any formal training in like electronic nomenclature. And when you first look at this guy, you see the words output here and then input here. So I thought that you hook up the 120 volt positive and negative here, and then the output on the lower voltage is here, just by the way they labeled it. That's not the case, because I hooked up the wires and blew my circuit and this thing popped. And I thought I ruined another power supply, but it saved itself. If you do get this guy, it seems like a pretty good product. Just make sure that this is actually not the output side. This is the input. You put the 120 neutral and load and ground on this side, and then over here is where you attach the LED lights to it. Just a heads up. Let's go ahead and take this apart because I need to mark the holes, these four holes, to mount it on the back of the TV. We'll be right back.
Up until last week, this was all I had for studio lighting. A little battery powered, rechargeable, janky one with paper towel taped over it to soften the light. And now I've got a nice big one. Look out, Steven Spielberg, here I come. So here I'm on the back side. You can actually adjust the voltage down a little bit to reduce the lighting so it's not so bright. Still pretty bright though. Color's not too bad. The blue bulbs kind of get subdued once that the three filters and then that last piece of plastic goes on there. But yeah, it's on a hinge, so it'll pivot. I've got it on a little temporary soccer tripod so I can actually push it to the ceiling if I want to get some downlighting. It's just a temporary solution, but yeah, it turned out great. Upcycling a busted LCD TV into a really professional studio/shop light.